Good evening. Today we will start with the second unit in computer graphics, and we shall be covering few points in this. Basically, this particular unit deals with the line drawing, horizontal line, vertical line, how to draw a horizontal line on the monitor, how to draw a vertical line on the monitor, and then we will be converting, scan converting a point and a line as discussed in the first unit. We will continue with that, and in this particular unit we are going to cover two algorithms, that is digital differential analyzer algorithm and Wessenham's line drawing algorithm. If time permits, we will continue with the rest of the two algorithms which are mentioned at the bottom, and we'll today start with this particular lecture now. If you see the lines on this particular object seem to be, this is a jug, and you will see that the lines are you will feel as if the lines are not straight, but actually if you go deeper into it, the lines are actually, they are made up of pixels and they are straight. Now the points and lines. Point plotting is accomplished by converting a single coordinate position furnished by an application program into appropriate operations for the output device in use. With a CRT monitor, for example, the electron beam is turned on to illuminate this screen phosphor at the selected location. Now, in this particular thing, point plotting is, because basically what we are doing, we are plotting the points onto the monitor and then we are converting it into the drawing, either we are drawing a line or we are drawing an arc. Basically plotting a point is most essential part of a CRT. Now let us see, if we think of a point P that is shown here in this particular diagram, pixel is always represented by its coordinate position. We can see that X and Y represent the value in X direction and value in Y direction, which is the coordinate positions as written here, single coordinate position. Set the bit value, color code is also there. In if we talk about Turbo C environment, we can fix up the color code also, and we'll use a function. Put pixel x comma y comma r, say for red color, and b for blue color, and so on. But generally this is the pseudo function that we are representing here, set pixel x comma y. So this means we are going to print, or we are going to plot or print a particular value of at a particular location. The location is specified by x and y values. Now this is very essential slide, please read this. Line drawing is accomplished by calculating intermediate positions along the line path between the specified endpoints. An output device is then directed to fill in these positions between the endpoints. So these two lines are very, very essential. Please let us go through them again. The line drawing is accomplished by calculating intermediate positions. Now the all the algorithms that presently we are going to learn are based upon concept of finding out the intermediate positions along the line path. Now how do we define a line path? The line path is defined by the starting position and the end position of the coordinate values of a line. Now if you want to draw a line, you must be given with two endpoints, that is the starting point and the ending point. So the next is the precise definition for line drawing. Given two points P and Q in the plane, both the integer coordinates determine the pixels on a raster screen should be on in order to make the picture of a unit width line segment starting from P and ending at Q. Okay, we want to draw a line starting from point P to Q. There will be intermittently large number of points. CRT is supposed to fill those points, and then the final picture will be a straight line. Now, if you see this particular diagram here, x1, y1, x2, y2. They are the starting and the ending points here, and they are integer values, and we have used this particular pseudo function set pixel x comma y. Now you will see that all the blocks, all these particular region are filled, and we get a straight line from x1 y1 to x2 y2. Now line rasterization requirements. Now in this particular thing, what are we supposed to see on the monitor? We want to see a straight line. We don't want any gaps. The accuracy, the speed, the brightness, the thickness, it should be continuous in nature. We should not have uneven lines. So that is what is expected. As if we are drawing a line with the help of a scale and a pencil, we want the same kind of line to be displayed onto the monitor. Now this is very essential pseudo code. Now you will see how to draw a horizontal line. Horizontal line means is obtained by keeping the y value constant and repeatedly incrementing the x value by 1 unit. Because we are moving, we have divided the whole the raster scan screen into unit pixel positions, and then we are able to see the pixels moving unit by unit. Now we see the second part of this slide, that is the pseudo code, is which says x star comma y to x end comma y, x star comma end to x. This one, I am talking about this one, x star, this is the star, x1, this is the starting pixel, this is y, and x end, this is this x2, or we can say the ending pixel, and x start less than equals to end. So we have to find out the points in between x1, y1, x2, y2. Now, since in this particular case we are drawing a horizontal line, the y value will remain constant. Now, this is the most important part of this particular loop. For x is equal to x start, x end, x plus plus, and put pixel x comma y comma 8. This put pixel function is a combo C function, and 8 is the print value of a particular color. Now, if x start greater than n, in the loop, you must start from the reverse order. That is, if we are given the ending point first and the starting point, then we have to reverse this order, and then we have to process the points. Now, if you see here, in this particular loop, the value of only x is touched. No y value has been modified. Only the x values are calculated. So this code is meant for horizontal drawing of lines on the monitor. Now next one is the vertical drawing of the lines. Now in this particular vertical drawing of the lines, you will see it is obtained by keeping the value of x constant. See, this is the most essential part. And repeatedly incrementing the y value by 1 unit. Now in this particular thing, we want to draw a vertical line. So in this particular case, the value of x remains constant and y value is varying. So here in this particular loop, that is most essential part of it, it is the same as we have done in the other case, but here we are using the value y, because we want to find out the values in terms of y. So this is the put pixel function x comma y comma a, which is the turbo C environmental function. Now in this particular diagram, if you see here at the top, we have a pixel represented as a log 3,3. Now you see here, this is the pixel, x value is 3 and y value is 3, and this is the pixel representation here. And similarly, if we want to draw a line, we already know the equation of the line, y is equal to mx plus b, and if we know the first point, then we can find out the rest of the points by using a particular algorithm. That is what we have to learn here. Now scan the vertical line. Cartesian slope intercept equation for a straight line is y is equal to mx plus b. Now this particular equation, we are already aware of this in the coordinate geometry, and this equation shows, this is the equation of the line, and this is the equation for the slope. That is, if we are given a line with two points x1, y1 and x2, y2, then we can find out the value of slope, that is y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. And this values can be entered here, and then we can modify it with the intercept value as b is equal to y1 minus and x1. So now this one, this is the most essential. Delta y is equal to m times delta x. Delta y is y2 minus y1, and m times delta x, that is the multiplication of slope value with the change in the value of x components. Now here delta x is equal to delta y upon m, and we are getting the this is the delta y, that is change in y values, that is y2 minus y1, and this is the slope of the line. Now in this particular, the equation of the basic for determining diffraction voltage in analog devices, we have already written, if the slope of the line is less than 1, then delta y is equal to n times delta x, and if the slope of the line is greater than 1, then delta x is equal to delta y upon m. Now for any given interval x, delta x along the line, we can compute the corresponding y interval delta y from y delta y is equal to m times delta x as we have seen earlier. Now similarly, we can obtain the x interval delta x corresponding to a specified delta y as delta x is equal to delta y upon m as we have already seen in the previous diagrams. So the equation forms the basis for determining the reflection voltage in analog devices. Now, for lines with slope magnitude less than 1, absolute value of m is less than 1, then delta x can be set proportional to the small horizontal deflection voltage, and the corresponding vertical deflection is then set proportional to delta y, and therefore we can write delta y is equal to m times delta x. Similarly, for the lines with slope magnitude greater than 1, that is absolute value of m is greater than 1, delta y can be set proportional to small vertical deflection voltage, and the corresponding horizontal deflection voltage is set proportional to delta x and calculated as delta x is equal to delta y upon m. Now, if the slope of the line is 1, that is m is equal to 1, therefore we have delta x is equal to delta y, and the horizontal and the vertical deflection voltages are equal. Now, in this particular slide, we see scan converting a line. On a raster system, lines are plotted with pixels and step sizes, horizontal and vertical direction. We have to plot the points and far up by pixel separation. Now, if we see here the line x0, y0 and x1, y1, and we also see dy and dx, delta y and delta x, and we can see the approximation, an ideal line. Ideal line means this is the expected line, but actually we do not get the expected line, we always get a different form. Now, scan converting a line, we must sample a line at discrete positions and determine the nearest pixel to the line at each sampled position. Now here in this particular diagram, we see x1 and y1, these are the points here, x1, y1, which represents here, and x2 and y2, which represents this particular point. We have to find out intermediate points. Now with respect to this, we have to find out this. With respect to this particular point on x-axis, we have to find out the particular point on y-axis. Similarly, for this particular point on x-axis, we have to find out a particular point on y-axis, similarly for the last point. And once we get all the points, then we can join them and we can get a final line on the monitor. Now, in this very simple solution is that, suppose in this particular diagram, it shows that we have a value 2, 2. Now, the value on x-axis is 2, value on y-axis is 2, and value on x-axis is 7, and value of y-axis is 5. Therefore, we want to find out the intermediate points. In order to find out the intermediate points, you need to find out the value of slope, that is the y value. Now, in this particular case, here this is x1, y1, and this is x2, y2. So, the formula for slope you already know, it is y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1. So, we can find out this and see in the slide. So, this way, first of all, we will draw the simple raster on a paper and then we can solve this. Now, this particular thing shows here y2 minus y1, 5 minus 2 and then x2 minus x1, 7 minus 2, and the value of slope is 3 by 5 and the value of v. So, how did we get this one value of v? We have got this value from the equation y is equal to mx plus b. So here we can find out the rest of the points. Now if we put the value here, say we have put the value 3 here. Now this for this particular point, 3, y is 3, then we have m, then we have 3 at mx, and then this one, then b value, this is the b value here that we have calculated, y is equal to mx plus b, this is the equation and we are putting the point, and the point is 2, 3 by 5. Y 2 3 by 5 and the value of x is 3. So it is 3, 2 3 by 5. Similarly, for 4, here x is 4, we want to find out this particular value. So how do we find out this value? It is m, x and b. So it will be this one. Similarly, for other points here. So we can find out the intermediate points to find out the value. Now this is the final thing. Now this is the approximation we have done here, and this is not exactly because it is 13 by 5, and this is approximately 3. We have mentioned 3 and 4 and 4. We have taken up the integer values, and we can see the line here. This is the line, and ultimately this is the final line that we are able to see on the contour. Now next, however, this approach is just way too slow. In particularly, look after the equation y is equal to mx plus b requires multiplication by m and x and rounding of the resulting. This is the last slide. We have seen the rounding of the resulting y coordinates. We need a faster solution. In the previous example, we chose to solve a parametric line equation to give us y coordinate for each point x, each unit x coordinate, and we have already chosen x is equal to y minus b upon m, and m already know either we can write y2 minus y1 upon x2 minus x1, or we can write y n minus y0 x n minus x0, and b value can be calculated as b equals to y0 minus m times x0. Now this 0, y0 and x0, they are the starting point. Y end and X end, they are the end points of the line. Now here the fourth point, that is we see here X4, 5, 1 by 3 by 5, we can see easily that the line doesn't look like a straight line. Yes, of course, if the line doesn't look like a straight line, because haphazardly we have chosen the solution as a round off problem is there in this particular thing. Now see here, we are able to see the line. And x3, x4, x5, but if we see the quick notes about the lines, if the slope of the line is between minus 1 and 1, then we can work out the y coordinate for the line based on its unit x coordinate. Otherwise we do the opposite, minus x coordinate are computed based on the unit y coordinates. Now we can see here these variation of the slopes of the lines depending upon these slopes, the values, if you see here, m is equal to 0, m is equal to 1 by 3, m is equal to 1 by 2, and then again it goes back to 0 from the negative end, m is equal to minus 4, minus 2, minus 1, minus half, 1 by, minus 1 by 3, and then 0. Now let us start with the DDA algorithm. With the full form of DDA algorithm is Digital Differential Analyzer algorithm. Now this particular algorithm is incremental scan conversion method based on calculating the value of delta y or delta x. We already know that m is equal to delta y upon delta x, and delta y can be written as the m times delta x. Since we already know the first thing, now we want to find out the rest of the points that are yk plus 1 is equal to yk plus n. Now this is the first point, that suppose we are given here x1, y1, and this is the end point x2, y2. Now we want to find out the intermediary points using the DDA algorithm. So next, the rest of the points can be found out by yk plus 1 is equal to yk plus m. Now we have to find out the value of m, which will create the line for us. Now if delta m greater than 1, delta y is equal to 1, and delta x is equal to delta y upon m, and xk plus 1 is equal to xk plus 1 by m. In this particular case, we see that the value of m, that is the value of slope, is greater than 1. And so in this case, what we are going to do, the delta y increment is step is assumed to be 1, and delta x value, that is the change in the increment x of x, is equal to delta y upon m. Delta y is the change in value of y, that is y2 minus y1, and m is the value of the slope. Now the next value of x, how to calculate the next value of x, that is xk plus 1 equals to xk plus 1 by m. Now m is the slope of the line. Here, so for the above case, it is assumed that the lines are to be processed from left hand to the right hand, end points of the line. Now here you see here delta x is minus 1 and delta y is minus 1. Now we can see the slope greater than 1. Now the value delta minus 1. If the process is reverse, suppose we are doing it in the reverse way, that is the higher values are known to us, then delta x is equal to minus 1, delta y is m times delta x, and yk plus 1 is equal to yk minus m. And if delta y is minus 1, then delta y is equal to m times delta x, xk plus 1 is equal to xk minus 1 by m. Now the pseudo code for DDA, let us see how we can implement this. This is a pseudo code. This is not an actual C code or any MATLAB code. It is just a code to represent the steps of the algorithm. Now this digital differential analyzer algorithm requires x0, x1, y0, y1 only these two points. And here we have taken them as floating types. And x and y values, variables we have taken up. X increment and y increment are also a type float, number of steps. Now if you see here, the number of steps can be calculated by rounding the values, round x minus round x 0. That is, how many steps are to be obtained. Then x increment is equal to x1 minus x0 divided by the number of steps. And y increment is y1 minus y0 divided by the number of steps. Now we have to start plotting it. This is the first point. X is equal to x0 and y is equal to y0. The meaning of this particular thing is we are allocating x0 to x and y0 to y, which are the initial points. Now we want to plot it because we want to have a color pixel and we want to draw it on the monitor. Round x and round y, we are using the round function here. For integer, I is equal to 0, I less than number of steps, I plus plus. X is equal to x increment and y increment here. And then again we are plotting the pixel. This is all the digital differential analyzer algorithm. It is based upon the fact that we have to calculate the x increment and y increment by using the number of steps. And first of all we have to plot the first point and then we have to calculate the rest of the points. Suppose we want to draw a line starting from 2, 3, ending at 12, 8. We can see here, in this particular example here, this is the example of DDA algorithm. The starting point is 2, 3 and the ending point is 12, 8. And now we have to find out the values of number of steps. If you see here, this is 12 minus 2 number of steps, that is x2 minus x1. This is 12 and this is 2 and this is 10 and x increment is 10 by 10 because x increment value has been calculated and y increment is also there. Now these are t stands for the number of steps for which we have to perform this, and the number of steps is 10 as indicated here. Now x and y, now we have to find out this initial value is the 2 and 3 because the starting value that has been given to us is 2, 3. This is the starting pixel. Now we have to note down. And in this, we have to, even if we round it, it becomes 2 and 3. And this 2 and 3 is to be plotted here. Now, 3, 3.5. Now, because we are incrementing the value of x, that is 2 plus 1 it becomes 3, and 3 plus 0.5 becomes 3.5 here. Now, in this particular case, but we need to have a rounded value 3, 4. Now in this particular case, it is already 4 and this is 4 here and we are getting here 4. Now next is 5, 4.5 and rest of the steps are as shown in the diagram. Major advantage in the above approach is faster method for calculating the pixel positions than the direct use, y is equal to mx plus c. It eliminates the multiplication by making use of raster characteristics so that appropriate increments are applied in the x or y direction to step the pixel positions along the line path. The major deficiency is rounding problem here. Because we are using a rounding operation here and it is a time consuming process and depends upon language to language. We can improve the performance of DDA algorithm by separating the increments m and 1 by m into integer and fractional parts so that the calculations are reduced to integer operations. So there is a problem of rounding, that is the major problem here, and otherwise this is a very good algorithm and it is able to calculate the intermediary points that are required. Now in this particular thing that we are able to see 2D Cartesian reference system, 2D Cartesian reference frame is there. This is a pixel and coordinate origin at the lower left screen and coordinate origin at the upper left screen. We can see here the two types of inputs. So lines, intermediate positions between two endpoints, DDA and Bresenham's, that we have already, DDA we have already done. Now the second method is the Bresenham's. Now this is the C algorithm for, we can see this C programming language algorithm is also there. We can see here we have taken up dx, dy and steps of the type integer, and dx we already know, xb minus xa, and that is x2 minus x1, and dy is y2 minus y1 or the yb minus y steps. X increment, y increment, xa and ya. Now, if the absolute value of dx is greater than absolute value of dy, then steps is equal to absolute value of dx, else steps is equal to absolute value of dy. This is the major point that we have to note down in the DDA algorithm. DDA algorithm is purely based. Now, what do we mean by absolute value? Only the magnitude part. We are concerned only with the magnitude part. So, we have checked the absolute value of dx, that is the magnitude of dx. If it is greater than absolute value of dy, then we have to perform steps is equal to absolute value of dx. Otherwise, the steps is equal to absolute value of dy, that is the magnitude of dy. Steps, what do we mean by steps? Steps means the number of times the loop is being repeated. We are going to learn the DDA algorithm. We have already seen the steps of DDA algorithm. Now, this is the C implementation of DDA algorithm here. In this particular slide, we are able to see that the function, we have taken up a function here, integer xa, integer ya, integer xb and integer yb, which represents the starting point and the ending point of a line. Now here integer dx is equal to xb minus xa. Now what does this represent? It represents x2 minus x1 that we have already done, and dy it represents y2 minus y1, or since we have taken up a and b as the starting and ending point, so here we are taking it as such. Steps and k value here, then the x increment, y increment, xa, ya. Now let us see the algorithm here. If the absolute value of dx is greater than absolute value of dy, then steps is equal to absolute value of dx. Now what is the basic point in this? The absolute value, we are comparing only the magnitude part here, and the dx, that is the x2 minus x1, and dy, y2 minus y1. If the magnitude of dx is greater than magnitude of dy, then we have to take the number of steps as dx. Otherwise, we have to take up the steps as dy. Now, in the second case, this one, x increment, that is, and y increment values we have to calculate. The x increment is calculated as x2 minus x1 upon the steps, number of steps that we have. And dy is y2 minus y1, and it is divided by the number of steps we have. Put pixel is a C function, already I have told you that it is a function here, and we are rounding the values, round x and round y, and then we are now in this particular case we want to display the values onto the monitor. This is the first point that is going to be there. Now what will be the first point? The first point will be x, a, y, a. Okay, with this. Now the next of the rest points can be calculated as using a for loop for k, steps k plus plus, x increment and y increment, and then put pixel. Now what is this x increment? X is equal to x plus increment, that is the previous value plus x increment. Y is y plus y increment, that is the previous value of y plus y increment, and then we are able to display it on the monitor. Now let us start with the Bresenham's algorithm. The Bresenham's line algorithm was given by Bresenham, and he has got a patent over this algorithm. And let us try to study his algorithm here. It is accurate, efficient raster scan line drawing algorithm developed by Bresenham. Scan converts the line using only incremental integer calculations that can be adapted to display circles and other curves. Keeping in mind the symmetry property of the lines, let's try a more efficient way of drawing a line. Now this is the most important part. We can draw better lines as compared to DDA. the starting from left end point x0 by 0 of a given line, we step to each successive column x position and plot the pixel whose scan line y value closest to the line path. Assuming we have determined the pixel at xk yk is to be displayed, we next need to decide which pixel to plot xk plus 1 to derive more efficient way of drawing the line. The starting point, that is the left hand pixel, will be at x0 by 0 and we need to find out the rest of the points, that is xk plus 1. Now, rest of the points are to be found out whether it will be xk plus 1 or yk plus 1 depending upon the algorithmic steps. Now, let us see here, in this particular case, if we see the point, this is xk, yk and this is the starting point here. This particular line has got two points. Now we have drawn only the first point. This equation of the line is given by y is equal to mx plus b. And this is the starting point here. And now we want to find out the rest of the points. So rest of the points can be xk plus 1 or yk plus 1 or it can be xk plus 1 yk. So we need to find out this particular thing, whether we have to choose xk plus 1 comma yk or xk plus 1 comma xk plus 1, and similarly for the rest of the points here. Now in this particular case, if we see here, this is the starting pixel xk yk which has been plotted here, and now we have to choose either the two. As I was telling you earlier, this is the value here. Either we have to choose this or we have to choose this to draw the line. Now, the value for this one will be xk plus 1 yk and this value for this one will be xk plus 1 yk plus 1. Now, if we go deeper into the this one, we see here we want to find out the next set of points. Here xk plus 1 is the next pixel to be chosen and we have to find out, the problem is to find out the value of y. So it will be, here it is shown here yk and here it shows yk, y and then yk plus 1. Now let us assume that d1 is your y minus yk and your d2 is yk plus 1 minus y. So we can find out this particular value here and then we can see. In this, the choices are, because we are getting only two choices, the xk plus 1 yk and xk plus 1 yk plus 1. These are the only two choices. Now what happens, let us take a decision parameter y minus yk and so we can write, we can replace the value of y as mx plus b and yk we can write and xk plus 1 yb minus k and similarly we can write d2 yk plus 1. Okay, and minus y and yk plus 1 and we have to write this particular equation of the line here. Now let us find out the difference between d2 and d1, that is d1 minus d2. Now we are calculating here, so we want to approximate further. D2 and xk plus 1 minus 2yk, this is the end result of d1 minus d2 here. A decision parameter pk for the kth step in the line algorithm can be obtained by rearranging the above equation so that it involves only integer calculations. Now in this case, if we see here, the decision parameter px is equal to delta x times d1 minus d2, delta x d1 minus d2 has been replaced here and now we can see here 2 times delta y xk minus 2 times delta x yk plus c. The sign of the pk is most essential part of it. The sign of pk is the same as the sign of d1 minus d2. Then delta x greater than 0, parameter c is constant and has the value in this one, independent of pixel position. Now this is slightly different algorithm than your DB algorithm. If pixel at yk is closer to the line path, then yk plus 1, and if d1 less than d2, then pk is negative and we plot the lower pixel in such a case, otherwise the upper pixel will be chosen. So this way we need to Now the coordinate changes along the line occur in one's unit steps in either the x or the y directions. Therefore, we can obtain the values of the successive decision parameters using the incremental integer calculations. Now here, if we see, we want to find out the next value of decision parameter at k plus 1. So pk plus 1 will be 2 times delta y xk plus 1, 2 times delta x yk plus 1 plus c. Now we will subtract pk plus 1 minus pk is 2 delta times xk plus 1 minus xk and 2 delta times x yk plus 1 y. Now this xk plus 1 is nothing but xk plus 1, that is the next value of the pixel. As we have written here, xk plus 1 is equal to xk plus 1. It is the next value of the pixel as earlier we have discussed. So therefore, we can write pk plus 1 is equal to pk 2 delta y minus 2 delta x and yk plus 1 minus yk. Where the term yk plus 1 minus yk is either 0 or 1 depending upon the sign of the parameter pk. The first parameter P0, we need to find out the first parameter directly, which can be computed as 2 delta y x0 and 2 delta x y0 plus c, which is equal to 2 delta y x0 minus 2b 2 delta x y0 plus 2 delta y plus 2 delta x 2b minus 1. So since x0 y0 satisfies the line equation, we also have y0 is equal to delta y upon delta x x0 plus b. Combining the above, we have method of finding out the starting point of decision parameter P0 is 2 delta y minus delta x. Here 2 delta y is the y2 minus y1 and delta x is the x2 minus x1. And if you want to find out the starting point, so this will give you the P0 value here. This can be easily calculated because we have the two pixels available with us, that is the starting and the ending. The constants 2 delta y, 2 delta y minus 2 delta x are calculated once each can be scanned and rotated. So the algorithm involves only additions and subtractions. Now let us see the pseudo algorithm here. Input the two endpoints and store the left endpoint in x0 y0. Now the starting value is to be stored here and load the x0 y0 into the frame buffer. Plot this first point. Now first point is to be plotted here, and after this we need to calculate the starting point of the decision parameter, which is calculated as 2 delta y minus delta x. So we can easily calculate it from the mathematics where we have learned earlier. Now at each xk along the line at k is equal to 0, perform the following. Now this is the most essential part of your Bresnahan's algorithm. If the value of pk, that is the decision parameter, is less than 0, then the next point is xk plus 1 comma yk. This is the most essential part, you have to note down, because with this value you are going to take the decision here. Now the next value of pk plus, next value of decision parameter will be pk plus 1 is equal to pk plus 2 delta y. And otherwise, plot of the point to be plotted is xk plus 1 comma yk plus 1. So, and the next value of pk plus 1 will be pk plus 2 delta y minus 2 times delta x. So, this is the difference between this, and repeat these steps delta x times. Now I want to show you the example, and then we will see the C code here. We are given two pixels 20,10 and 30,18 here, and now we want to find out delta x value. The delta x value will be 30 minus 20 is 10 and 18 minus 10 is 8. That is y2 minus y1 and x2 minus x1 values have been obtained from given pixels. Now we want to find out the initial decision parameter. The initial decision parameter can be calculated by the formula 2 delta y minus delta x. So 2 delta y minus delta x is 16 minus 10, it is equal to 6 here. And the increments, we will immediately calculate the values 2 delta y and 2 delta y minus 2 delta x also, and we have calculated it on here. Now let us start the algorithm here to find out the other points. The starting pixel 0, the decision parameter, that is this value, is written here 6. And the value, because this particular value, now what do we do? Because we have to make a decision here. Now this value is 6. So what does this indicate? In the earlier slide we had written that now if we see here the x value will be xk plus 1 comma yk plus 1. From here only we are starting. So the next, again we have to calculate the next parameter, that will be 6 plus 2 delta y minus 2 delta x. That is, this value is to be calculated here. So this way we need to find out the points, and the rest of the points are here, and these are the values from the starting point 20, 10 say, to 30, 18. So now let us see the C algorithm here. Now this is the C algorithm. Brezhnev line, we need to draw xa, ya, xb, yb, and then absolute value of xa minus xb, that is your x2 minus x1, and delta y is y2 minus y1, and integer value, that is the starting value of e, is 2 times delta y minus delta x, and 2 delta y is 2 delta y, and again we can calculate 2 delta y minus delta x, integer x, and then n. Now we need to determine the other rest of the points here, and then the rest of the points can be calculated as if xa greater than xb, x is equal to xb, y is equal to yb, xn, xa. This is the initial thing that we have to do. And else x is equal to xa and y is equal to ya, xn is equal to xb. Now set pixel x, y. This is the starting pixel that we have plotted here, and this is the most essential part which will modify the algorithm. Now y x less than xn. How many steps are to be observed? X less than xn. Because xn is the ending point of the given problem. X plus plus if b less than 0, b plus 2 delta y, else y plus plus 2 delta y delta x. Set pixel x, y. So this way we have attempted the Brezhnev's algorithm. Now similarly, you can see other example of this one. I have taken up 2, 3, 12, 8 again, and we have taken up in earlier case also. So we can take up the values. 2, 3 is the starting point and 12, 8 is the ending point. We can find out the value of dx, then we can find out the value of dy, then we have to find out the value of initial decision parameter b0, and then we have to find out the value of 2 delta y and 2 delta y minus 2 delta x, which is equal to 10. Now at the starting we will plot this 2, 3, which is the starting point here. Then at the first, then we have to find out this particular decision parameter p. So it is equal to this value, because we have to calculate this and then and from there we have to find out the next set of points as we have already discussed. So rest of the slides we will be attempting in the